What's very important is, in a matter of seconds, at some point, there are always going to be obstacles in life where that all goes away. By a show of hands, how many have had something occur in their life where they did lose everything and had to start over at some point? See? Some are willing to share, some will not, and some haven't really been there yet. But it will happen. That's how life happens. I want to share with you, I had something happen, and I was working in property management. My dad is J.B. Durham. I don't know if any of you know who that is. But I learned property management from the young age of 8, and I had to go and apply it with my lifestyle. And it was a passion. It wasn't like, oh, your dad got your foot in the door. It was like, no, you have to work twice as hard or you will be removed. But I was having a great career, starting at the low end of leasing management. I went all the way up to property management in DFW. We moved to San Antonio, new property. I found my career. I was very successful at it. I knew I wanted this to be my lifestyle. I was moving up the ladder at a very fast rate. Not because my dad, but because my own goals and making those turn into reality. But unexpectedly, just like life's missions, I was in a very bad car versus motorcycle accident 7 years ago and I passed away. And I woke up 5 weeks randomly later with a traumatic brain injury. And my whole life ended. I didn't even know who I was or where I was or how to function, talk, walk, yes, no, even keep my head up. But I had to start all over. And we've all had to do that. But when you have the power to change your own personal mindset, and just like Tom stated, which is very true, what you feed your mind determines your appetite. Because let's be honest, you are who you are and where you are in life every step of the way for what you personally allow to process up inside your noggin. Because no one else controls your own personal mindset. We can all get information from others, but it's that famous phrase, in one ear, out the other. Some of it sits, and then we change the perspective. But they're not us. So I want to share with you some personal positivity that I use every step of the way, not only from the beginning of my injury, but also throughout, because of a traumatic brain injury, especially a severe, is a lifelong journey of difficulties. Not saying that, oh, a normal life is not difficulties, but let's be honest, the word normal is kind of overrated. Can I get an agreement with that? Yeah, there you go, it's even out loud, look at me up. Well, starting every day and living it at the moment. That's number one. And when living it at the moment, that means literally 1 second at a time. Because when you think about that in the long term, the seconds turn into minutes. Minutes into hours. Hours into days. Days into months, weeks, years, and so on. And when you look at that from a different perspective, instead of thinking, oh, I'm just not doing that, it's the same as someone else, it's with the ancient Chinese philosophy, the little steps really are the big steps. And that's what we need to understand, that life is about completing, not competing. We're always going to have other role models, especially in the LU format. I want to be like that, but guess what? They're not you and you're not them. You can get some inspirational guidance for them, but at the end of the day, it's all up to you. And that unfolds to rule number two. Find at least one positive thought of your personal self throughout the day. It can be at the beginning, the middle, or the end. How many, by a show of hands, think that positivity is important throughout your life? There you go, we all got positive minds. Look at that. Well, you know what? We have to continue the positive mindset every day because it doesn't stick. And neither does bathing. That's why we have to do them both constantly. Because if you don't have a positive mindset or you don't have a positive body, you're going to have a stinky environment. And nobody wants to be around that and you can't think clearly. The third step of that is show an act of kindness. Not only to your inner circle, but most importantly, your outer circle. Because there's always going to be someone that needs to be lifted up. And we live in such a judgmental environment and world. That's not the first time this has been going on. It's been occurring centuries. But when you do that by either just say hello to someone, open the door, give them a smile. Obviously, you might not get the same reaction you're expecting, verbal or nonverbal, but you could be the highlight of their life. It could be that day, that week, that month, that year, I mean, for a series of it, and they're like, wow, it's not just because someone I know. It shows that there are positive, loving people out there. And once you do that, it's not only significant to them, of course, but it's a win-win ratio because you have the ability to leave your personal bubble. And when you think outside the box, different stuff will occur. And we don't have the food or anything. We want to always do what we know because, hey, we know what's going to happen. We're not worry-free. But when you try something new, positive opportunities unfold themselves, and you get to think better, be better, and most importantly, live better. So I want you guys to know that we all have such a blessing, such an opportunity to think, be, and live positively successful when you personally put your own mind to it. If you guys would like to learn any more information about me, or like Tom said, I do run a nonprofit organization called TBI One Love, and we spread a positive form of hope, inspiration, and education to those that have submitted a brain injury, along with prevention and awareness, because everyone has a difficulty in life. But once you understand that they did it, why can't you? You're already motivating yourself all naturally. Simple as that. And when Tom will explain more some detail about the Ziegler legacy, and I'm a proud member of that, just like I'm a proud member of LU, it's amazing how it not only will personally help you both in your personal and vocational lifestyles succeed in all aspects, permanently, but also it has helped me with my organization being able to reach people globally, spread the power of positivity, and let them know goals do become achievements. It might take longer to get where you're destined to be, but it's not about how fast you get there, it's what you become during the process. I want to thank you, Tom, and also another mentor, Howard Partridge. I highly suggest all of you keep in contact with them and get to know them, because that's not only a long-term blessing, but it's an opportunity of a lifetime. Thank you all for the blessing. I look forward to hearing from you both. One love.